The DJI SRD Transmission Combo. Is it worth $600? Yeah, I know marketing says $549. That's not what came out of my pocket. That'd be closer to $600. So will you drop $600+ on this DJI product? Hi, Bear Brimer here again. I've worked as a creator for over 45 years and have used tools of all sorts to produce creative results for a variety of clients. This is my thoughts on equipment I purchased. Today we're talking about the DJI SRD Transmission Combo. Let's crack on. What will we compare it to? The DJI's bigger brother of transmission at $2,700, marketing $2,499, or something like the Axun Sinai video transmitter. I bought one back in 2020 after watching a review by DSLR shooters. Let's say it's not my favorite purchase. Let's look at four things you'll learn from this video, hopefully before you buy it. And if you do buy it, you will benefit by watching to the end of the video. There's a free PDF download that highlights all the information here and includes a quick reference for when you own the DJI transmitter. Did I just give away what I think? So, I said four things. Thing one, the pros. Thing two, the cons. Thing three, how I use it. Thing four, what would make it even better? Thing one, the pros. Why I think it's great. The first thing under the pros is, yes, distance. DJI claims line of sight, 3 kilometers or 10,000 feet. That's 1.8 miles at 1080p, 60 frames a second. Look, if you're more than half a mile, which is 2,640 feet from any of my video shoots, you just weren't invited in the first place. Number two is easy connection. This is something I really appreciate on a small video production shoot. I no longer have to jump through hoops to provide a client with views of what is being shot. With so many things to do on set, it quickly and easily connects, stays connected, so I can focus on more important tasks. Three is flexible connection. Because it's a dual system of SDR and Wi-Fi, it handles connections without me having to troubleshoot, unlike Wi-Fi only. Number four, quality. This unit strikes a balance between transmission on set and high bit rate. High image quality of 1080p at 60 frames a second and a transmission bit rate of up to 20 megabytes per second. That gives my clients more quality than they need to review what's going on set. Five, latency. With a minimal latency of 35 milliseconds, if camera and screen display latency are included, the data is 80 milliseconds. Even at that, it works great for client preview. Stable connection. Yes, DJI calls it SDR, Software Defined Radio Technology, and Wi-Fi video transmission modes. And I'm beginning to sound a little bit like a salesman, but it does provide enhanced stability, interference resistance, penetration capabilities. And number seven, it's small. This surprised me when I received the combo. Both units are small, lightweight, smaller than I thought they would be. Some people say it being plastic is a downside and it'll break easily, which may be true, but we take good care of our equipment, so I don't see this being an issue for us. And number eight is price. At $600, marketing $549, I jumped on this as soon as I saw it was available to order. To compare, the CineView Multispectrum is $470 for the combo, which is much less capable. With a distance up to 1,200 feet, latency is 500 milliseconds and less I/O. Over 4 years ago, I spent $160 on the Axun Sinai video transmitter, which I used once. To be fair, DSLR shooters recommended it as part of an easy way to set up remote focus pull. I guess it worked for that, but I was unimpressed with my purchase. So, thing two, the cons. What needs work? Well, it runs hot. So much so there's a warning in the manual, and you can adjust the fans a little bit. Two, it arrives dead. What I mean by that is it's unable to be used directly out of the box. And I've never liked that approach to hardware and software. You must go online, download software to your computer, set it up with your DJI account. If you don't have one, set that up. Then after you've got that all set up, then you have to download the product firmware. Then you have to update the firmware on both units. I understand having firmware updates over time, but not out of the box. I just don't like that. The third con is the receiver is kind of loudish. I ran a test for over an hour on a single NPF battery, and at times it measured the fan noise up to 60 dB. Yes, I was close, and yes, you can change the fan from standard to low, but the unit may overheat as stated in the manual, so you've got to be careful there. And number four, the accessories for the iPhone and the iPad mounting here, both together set you back $110. That's a little much, I think. And the iPad mount, it will not work for larger iPads. So, thing three, how I use it. I use it mostly for client preview on site. I mentioned before that the receiver is a bit loud, and thus you need to keep it at least 15 to 20 feet away from any sound being recorded on stage. But for how I use it, that's really not an issue. I usually have a client either 20 feet away or maybe in a nearby conference room watching what's going on set. The second way I use it is in-house photo shoots and headshots. I normally shoot headshots in a studio where I shoot tethered, and all my strobes are on battery to keep me from tripping. I like to have a large vanity monitor, a big preview TV at least 48 inches, in the studio for the client. With this, I have the flexibility to move it wherever I want and have no wires. Three, another place I found that it's useful is in live streaming. I can use the iPhone with its video out adapter connected to the transmitter. Using the Blackmagic camera app with clean HDMI out. Then I connect the receiver into the HDMI on the Blackmagic ATEM. This makes for great second camera I can use in a Zoom call or for live streaming. Thing four, what needs to be added? I use the Pocket 3, and this connects to the USB cable to an HDMI, but it does not in any way work with the SDR transmitter. I would like a firmware update to the Pocket 3 to connect directly with the transmitter. So technically that's not a DJI SDR thing, that's a Pocket thing. So the answer is yes, I did spend $710 including holders, and I'm glad I did. This is the best and easiest to use transmitter for the price. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this informative and valuable. If you'd like to subscribe, you know how, or leave a comment and questions below. Oh yeah, the link to the PDF is in the notes below. As always, see you in the next video. Now creators, crack on!